Hello there, beloved Ascension Pioneers, and welcome to this very important Ascension update, which I want to share with all of you. I've prepared some notes so that I really don't forget to exclude anything from the list of what I wish to talk to about today. So this video in particular will come in three parts. The first part will be like an energy update, then I'll have a bit of a galactic update, and the third part will be me playing music, so playing a sacred attunement for what we're going through right now, so the energy attunement for where we are. So in the beginning I want to talk a little about this, what is taking place energetically. When you go through your ascension, you start to feel things more. You start to see what comes to your own self. And you, as I've shared before, begin to become your own guide more and more. So take this, what I'm sharing, as what resonates with you for where you are in your own journey at this time. So in particular, what I've been going through to this time is, you know, this July, which was so intense, a lot of us felt probably that it's going to be something, but at the end, it maybe turned out as to something else. So after certain initiations we've been having and certain healing and holding that took place from within, you might have answers to why things took place the way they did. And a lot of clarity comes after we move through a certain initiation. So July was really meant for healing, for the self-healing. And we had so many planets retrograde that this was, of course, due necessary for us. So August, in terms, will be more light in energy. So August has, let's say, more playful energy, but again, it depends on where we are, how much we've moved through this threshold, and how much inner healing took place. So as you know, healing and holding for our ascension as an ascension pioneer always comes first. So maybe you wanted to do something else, but then in the end, it didn't turn out. For me, I wanted to take a trip, but it didn't really come out. I wasn't guided at all. And I always followed the guidance of my internal knowing. And when I do that, I get rewards, which are proper alignments and adjustments for myself, where I am vibrationally. As you know, the whole frequency thing is what's really essential here in our ascension. Not so much physically what we do, where we are located, what we're experiencing. This comes after. This comes as, with each initiation, then we know. Let's say you move through a certain gateway in your own way, and then you know what you're guided to do next. But July was very much static in that way that we needed to remain very present with our healing. This is how I experienced energy. Because a lot of times before, when we kept showing the way, we gave so much of ourselves that sometimes we forget what it is to just be ourselves. And this is very natural for those of you maybe who are healers and doing energy work, whatever you're doing, participating in this light movement on the planet right now. And it's very important because healing needs to come first. So this full moon in Aquarius, which I'm recording this video today on the day of the full moon, the last of July, which was very intense, this actually sets the tone for the whole month of August. So we had two full moons in July, but we're going to have a full moon in Pisces at the end of August, which is going to be more dreamy and more introverted. The whole of August can be felt more extroverted than it was in July. If you felt too much extroverted, then in July you felt maybe lots of restriction coming through, because Spirit really wants us to be present with our own healing. What this means is a lot of beliefs were coming up, and when beliefs persist through certain genetic lines, so when they're through the ancestral lineage, when they persist, they become patterns. And as you know, patterns can be very scattered. They can hide themselves to certain places. So when you think of yourself and your healing, and a lot of times people say, when will this healing be over? You know, am I finally done with it? Imagine lineages and lineages of your ancestral line. And then you want to get everything done, let's say, in 1 year, then you're really not getting the whole point of ascension, what it is. It's a journey, it's a process, it's not an event. And it's not something you're forcefully going through. It needs to be occurring through divine grace. So grace is pouring out through each passageway we make. It's then rewarded. So when we stay present with our spirit self, then we get these rewards, like confirmation, synchronization, more of abundance on all levels, because we get supported for where we need to be. If we're lacking support, it only means maybe we're not properly aligned. It's not that the universe is not hearing or calling for support. It just means maybe we're not aligned with where we need to be right now. So we really need to learn to flow with the energy. So this full moon really sets up this tone of freeing ourselves up, taking a leap of faith, and really being over with certain parts of us that we felt so attached to, like clinging to certain patterns. A lot of this is this self-forgiveness. You know, I'm gonna refer to a certain movie in this update a lot because it has some brilliant messages. The movie's called Insurgent, and it came out in March, and I've seen it just this week, and there's some really deep messages there. So when she's being tested through this simulation, and she's going through these passageways, and this one of these last passageways, then the enemy, the opposer, says to her, well, you're not gonna fight me, you're gonna fight your own enemy, your worst enemy, which is you. So she needs to meet herself, confront herself, all of her fears and all that she was judging herself with, although nothing was there, she was pure, she was doing always the right things. But still, even though we can, sometimes there's this feeling like we're not doing enough, like we're still judging ourselves. There's these tiny little worms, which I call them, nibbling at us. And this is something that in July, for those of you really moving deep, you know, being courageous enough to do this deep diving, then you know what this means. So this setting of the tone can be very much felt as the need to free ourselves, the need to be lighter. And this is how it is for now. So now let us begin with the description of August. August has an eighth frequency. It's an eighth universal month within an eighth universal year. What does this mean? You know, in each August we have Lion's Gate. We have Sirian Gateway on 8th of 8. And this year this happens in a triple code because the whole year is of the vibration 8 as well. So some people call this the Magdalene Gateway, the Diamond Portal, you know, many different things. I don't call it anything specific like that, but it does feel lighter, like freedom, like really courageously moving through that freedom, which is self-given. Nobody gives you freedom. You need to give that gift of freedom, of your thoughts, of your actions, of your choices to yourself. And this activates this triple gateway of soul alchemy on the 8th of May. This year is very special. So this triple energy happens at the Sirian Gateway, the 888 portal, and some really call this like this immense gateway, which is huge and vast. But the thing is that every time we put a certain name to something, and I've been receiving certain descriptions of these gateways myself, but Spirit shows me that sometimes when we do this with a lot of beings, there comes lots of expectation. You say, oh, you know, this gateway is going to happen, so I'm probably going to experience this. And if you haven't yet been initiated into that, it doesn't mean it's something exclusive, but you need to vibrationally align yourself with that, which is an opportunity. It's gateways are opportunities for those who are moving along with them, and maybe some people are not initiated that. You know, sometimes we want quick results, quick solutions, quick fixes, and that doesn't always come this way. I mean, it doesn't come this way at all. So I've really been avoiding of calling it something, because sometimes we say, wow, you know, this will happen, and a lot of mental projections can come through it, and we say, wow, this means this and that, because our mind can jump to so many conclusions. So in truth, this gateway is in a way a diamond gateway, but we need to be initiated, we need to be ready. And when I share certain things only in my mastery courses, it's not that I'm hiding information from those who are just watching here for free on YouTube. It means that it's not for everybody, it's for those beings who really feel ready and called and to do the work of devotion to their own personal mastery to be initiated. It's not for everybody, and this is how I receive from Spirit. You can, you know, sometimes people already tell me they don't know what I'm talking about in my videos, and this is what I mean when I talk about this. So this diamond light, what does it mean? People say not a lot of beings hold this diamond light frequency. Well, the diamond light frequency, the frequency of the seraphim, it's very much connected with the seraphim. And you know, my whole page is dedicated to the essence of this frequency, to the diamond light, to the purity, to the utmost purity of our angelic creation self. So this seraphim light is very few hold this frequency and are able to hold it. This means that they become a living gateway for this energy that it can then pour out into this planet. And only the initiated ones that know what this is, they feel what it is, and sometimes we don't consciously know it. We just know we have to embody this. For me, I don't even think about this names as such. I just know that I need to stay in this purity. Sometimes there's things coming, and you need to make choices whether you're going to align with this or not, and you need to stay, you know, aligned with this purity to dedicate yourself in service to this diamond light frequency. So not everybody will be ready for a certain quotum of light and holding pure frequency of this certain light. So the diamond highest light does represent purity in its essential form, and it does activate our own inner diamond heart, our diamond pure heart essence. So now let's move on to the galactic update. I want to share some galactic things that are happening in symbology. Again, I'm going to refer to this movie because it's really awesome. So if you've seen the movie Insurgent, you're going to see that they hold people in these segments, like they belong to a certain caste, they belong to a certain group. You know, the let's say those who are unselfish, those who are peaceful ones, those who are rebellious, they're more like daring ones. And there's, you know, castes like this. So at the end of the movie, you can see, because they fear these people who have codes, that they belong to more of these groups. So they fear them and they want to eliminate them. But in the end, they open this box. I'm sorry if I'm telling too much about the movie, but what it comes out is their ancestors who made and designed them in order to be in a certain way, a project of humanity. They tell them that they need that. They need these beings because they actually show how important it is to develop all these skills. So instantly I knew that a lot of times, you know, people only focus on, let's say, you only need to be humble, or you only need to be kind, or you only need to be sacrificial. But then you forget about discernment and wisdom and strong and vigilant and all these capabilities. So you can see even in the movie that those who develop only one particular frequency, only one particular story that they're aligning themselves with, let's say it's connected with an archetype. Let's say I'm only an unselfish being, but they didn't develop yet the mind to make the kind of logical assumptions that are really reasonable for the choices they make on a global level. So you can't do that. You know, humanity has been putting itself into these boxes for so long, and yet when you develop your whole, let's say, your pure, it really is connected in a way with that diamond light we've talked about. You really embody this pure potential of your crystalline DNA. It means that you're not just kind or graceful or loving, you're also smart, you're also very intelligent. You can have brain capacity that can make choices. You can make quick assumptions that are not lower mind assumptions, but they're dedicated to discernment. They come from wisdom. And that's why when she was holding that capacity, belonging to all these groups, she could pass those stimulations because she could make conclusions on all these multi-levels. So this does speak about our multidimensionality. So people, we need these soul essences, not just one. So what happened is, the second message of this movie was about our forefathers, so those who created us. There's a great alignment with what's really taking place with humanity, is because the ETs were involved with the human race, and they did initiate the human race, and they did start off the human race, and then they left because the humans needed to evolve on their own. They needed to develop these soul essences, you know, all of them. And when they actually, when someone was able to open the box, they said, well, now you're finally ready to join us, you know, you can join us now. So this really does talk about this joining the galactic lineage, joining ourselves, conjoining with this galactic consciousness that is always there available for us, but we need to develop it. There needs to be soul expansion and evolution. So also, this message is about our galactic forefathers, our galactic family, because you've seen in our collective, there's been so much talking about ETs returning, you know, the disclosure, starseeds, you know, we're going to have full confrontal with our galactic family. And the thing is that there's this longing to meet them, to reunite with them. And we've always been one, but the humanity has its own cycle. It has its own cycles, and it needed to evolve in a certain way. So this longing and to join them, and means that we're actually our own disclosure. We're becoming as them. We're becoming more evolved, more expanded. We are activating ourselves. And what I call this the five-pointed star microcosm consciousness, when you are the perfected human being, and then you're starting to, from there on, perfect and refine your physical embodiment. So there, we need to come to a certain level to join that consciousness, maybe that the other galactics hold. And this means that this longing to have that done externally from them needs to be replaced with self-love and self-evolution. So the ETs created the humankind and then they left, and ever since then we've had the separation. We had the separation consciousness, like this longing, you know, we felt separate, we felt alone. There were so many beings feeling stranded and abandoned, and finally They were feeling separate from source because they confused these forefathers as their source, and yet they're not. They're just brothers and sisters. And although they had the wisdom that they attained through their own initiations and activations, then they passed it on to create, to co-create with the divine. It's all divine. It's not that some beings are separate from it. And this longing has just been this longing to once again re-embrace our own I Am God Self, and to return to our galactic family lineage by becoming this, by becoming our own God Sovereign Selves, by becoming involved in all these soul essences. And this desire is for soul expansion and evolution from our galactic brotherhood. It's for our own gain. It's not that they have abandoned us. It was all done for us, because everybody needs to evolve on their own, in their own timing, in their own space. So there's this pure benevolence involved with that. And we need to finally start seeing that and experiencing ourselves as great beings, as disclosure, as we're always connected. There, you know, this feeling of separation needs to be really replaced with the love of union. So they're not our source. They're just parts of source like we are. And they're our ancestors as we are our own beings, and our source, our I Am. And this is within. So we need to grow into our own I Am-ness and in sovereignty. So the next thing that is connected with this also is splitting consciousness. A lot of people are now feeling with this longing, like they're in this world, the reality is different, but the outer doesn't match it yet. What this means is that this longing for something greater sometimes happens, or people want to be joining other groups, and they want to have spiritual friends, or they want to finally something to begin physically as well, and they're not feeling it in their lives or their environment. This means that our inner and outer reality are not yet the same. They're not yet equalized, because many people who are longing for these companionships and these things that they feel they're not having are not yet seeing that we're bridging the way, we're bridging these gaps, and we're still in the space in between. So what this means is that our reality continues to expand, and we know that consciousness we're tapping into by how we feel. So let's say we feel like void and nothing's happening, and you do something but it feels empty to you. Let's say you're wanting to participate more in these basic 3D lifestyles or realities, and you're not feeling something. It means you're tapping into something where your consciousness no longer resides. You're no longer there, but you're still trying to be there. You don't belong there anymore. And it's hard for you because you feel if you align with that, there's nobody there standing with you. But you are the bridgeway. If you are standing there at the front lines, then you are the one who is bridging the gaps. I know it can feel isolated, lonely, but remember what I've shared before about the galactic forefathers. It's, in a way, we are also these forefathers for those who are coming after us in consciousness. So if you feel then bliss instead, and joy and lots of creativity, then you know you're tapping into the new, the five-dimensional reality and beyond. And we need lots of patience with our process of ascension, with ourselves and self-love, lots of inner embracing also of our inner child, because this is a process, it's not a goal, and it's a constant job in a way, and it's our job. And when you take the initiative to begin this ascension journey, you know it's going to be a long journey. It's not going to be something you can get out of it easily. We all had moments when we said, oh, get me out of this, I don't want to be here, I don't want to do this, I feel so, I feel I want to be in this new, but there's no resources here. A lot of people say they want resources to finally start their new lives. But again, like I said, if there's something not there yet, how can we not trust that it's also a way, you know, how things need to be? Because we're all so easily trusting when we have that abundance and we feel aligned. And a lot of times we say, wow, thank you, Source, for all this. But then we don't trust ourselves. Have you ever thought about the fact that we say, I have faith in God, but people then, they don't have their own confidence in their own selves. But you are part of the God. So how can you have faith in the divine and all something greater than you? But at the same time, we've lost this connection with really just trusting ourselves too, being confident. I mean, it's all one and the same. Every master will tell you this. You are. You are. Your first name is the I Am. So with this, I also want to say a bit about this return of love. Remember, lots of planetary retrogrades, Venus, because it's so important now. It's where we are. And these retrograding planets in Venus, for example, and how August begins with Saturn and Jupiter in square positioning, which sometimes can be called as very challenging, it just means that there needs to be commitment to expansion. And I was thinking about, okay, it means different things to different people, but for me, what it means and how Spirit chose me is there's commitment to the self, because Jupiter as expansion, and you know, our soul expansion and growth, it's, we need to, in our ascension, commit to ourselves. And Saturn is that commitment. And sometimes there comes a feeling of restriction, but they're not restrictions. It's just the feeling that when you decide for something, you can't also be somewhere else. You know, you say, okay, I'm gonna move forward into higher dimensions, but at the same time, I don't wanna leave lower dimensions. How is this possible? You want your cake and eat it too. That can't be done. So it might feel challenging, but it's for us. It's for us to expand into. So, to really commit to ourselves, who we are. That's why Venus is here and retrograding, because we need to really redefine our values. Who's first in our life? It's always us. So it's something that we need to develop, is that we come first, because we are that I am, and from that I am, everything else expands. So the micro within the macro and vice versa. And we need to know that having faith in the divine is also fully being confident in yourself, because you're never separate from that. We still have those separations, you know, we pray to God, but then in our own lives we don't trust ourselves. Well, how can we not then allow that we can conduct this higher discerned reality of the divine logic and heart and everything? We can, we really can. So this self-love with Venus comes first right now. I'm gonna tell you one example that I've been starting to think about today, and I asked, why is this on my mind today? It was very simple, because it's an example of this. A lot of times when we had this fall, let's call it fall, from that true grace, in grace there's always innocence and this purity. And I want to remind you, if you had your own example or experience of that first love. And today I was reminded of my first love in high school. It was in the beginning of high school. And I started remembering it from the point of how it felt, not the events or things that took place. And I remember this is when it really felt innocent. You know, for me, from my own example, it felt like I have a best friend. It felt like I have a buddy. I have the other part of me who's always there. It was very pure. There was no, even physically it was pure. It was like high school sweethearts. It was really pure. And I started to remember that. And then how, you know, the downfall of it came and why. And it's just because these outer things come to challenge people, and then people get afraid. And then they start to live their lives in a different way. And with that comes, in a way, the loss of that innocence. And I started to think about that. That with this return of this diamond light, it comes the return of our innocence, of that which was lost. So start to ponder on how does that feeling of first love feel. And for me, it was not attached. It was not one of those stories. It was actually rather beautiful. And everything aligned. Everything was so perfect and romantic. But the most basic essence that was there was this platonic love and this understanding that took place. It wasn't that attached feeling, but it was that understanding, that mutual understanding. When you had someone, you thought they really see you for where you were at that point. You know, you weren't a fully developed individual yet at that time. But in a way, because of that, we also didn't have so much of this identity, this personal identity, which is not the same as your sovereign soul self. So when we find this middle space, you know, this between, then we can find this innocence and allow it to return into our lives. So for me, that innocence, when it's lost, people start to get into these compulsive behaviors, and they start to search for something outside of them. When what we really need is that true companionship, first for ourselves, be our best friend, be our buddy. Because for me, if I remember that, at that time when that was over after a few years, it felt like, wow, I've lost best friend. And from there on, I started to feel how I am, in a way, losing myself too. So I started to think about this today and how important it is to keep that memory of that alive, because it's an energy essence. It's not about going back into the past or retrograding, but in a way, Venus retrograde can bring those feelings of nostalgia. But it's about remembering what is at the prime level of everything, and that's love, and love in pure companionship, which is soul understanding. When you and another are just through mirrors, and even that in the end it ends, because it needs to, you know, you have your own path and maybe they have theirs, but when you can keep this pure vision of things being the way they need to be and why, and knowing how much you've grown from there, but then returning back. So let's say you were innocent, then you went out in the world in a different way, you started searching for something, you developed, sometimes people develop this heart skin, and now with all this knowledge and with all this that we've learned, we can return to innocence. Innocence is returning, and it is fully returning. When you do that inner work, it will be paid off. You'll get confirmations, you'll get waves of abundance. You'll know you're on the right path because you'll feel different from internally. You know, a lot of people who've been going through my mastery courses have been telling me, you know, for years they've been following me, and they said now they finally know, after a few years, how it is to live that, not just know it, and they feel changes, they feel differences. And I love that. I love hearing that from all of you who have been going through this physically, because it needs to be a physical expression. And today I was here in this beautiful day on the beach, and I was just browsing for my beautiful stones to work and put into my art. And I felt, wow, if everybody was like this, then I'd be in heaven. I don't need much more. It's just me and the stones and the beach and the sun. And, you know, many times we need that contrast so that we can appreciate it, that we can really feel. So that's why we return to that feeling, to that essence. Okay, innocence, how does it feel? And how does it feel to be fully loved? And then loving yourself that same way. Because it came externally because you were at that point. You were innocent. And then now you're returning to it. We are returning. So we are purity, we are angelic, we are divine grace. And in this third part, I want to play you some music, which will be sourced. What this means is that sometimes people tell me about my music and they compare it with other music, but please don't do that, because any creation, the moment we define it or label it and compare it, it loses that source essence, which is totally momentary. It's source, it means it's in this now moment. So for me, I know how my I am works through me. It's in a very unique way, and I could not compare it as just as much. I couldn't compare other musicians or other creators. Everything is so individualized, and it's beautiful. But art, when truly is sourced, it's in motion, it's moving. And just this week, I think Moji posted video about this when he shared his own expression of how he moved through his years of art. And it was like, wow, exactly what I've always felt. You can't put it in a box. For example, I can't make what I do industrial, you know, like making a business, making a profit. Whenever I think about this, I lose the sense of creativity, which is pure. It needs to be spirit infused. It needs to be for the love of that creativity. It doesn't matter what happens with it. Someone gets it, someone buys it, someone this and that. I don't care. What really matters is this purity when you're doing something, and to not label or define it, because it's in motion, it's in movement. So when I'm going to do music, I'm going to play you something in this last part. It's just what comes in the now. It's going to be aligned. The only intention I will have is to be aligned with what we're going through now, with this gateway, with your own gateway, that you receive what you need to at this time through your own attunement. But it will be the song of our inner freedom, to really free ourselves, to really set the tone for this beautiful experience and what comes next. And you know, there always will be more coming next. So this return of grace, I want to invite into this art piece. But I also have, before I end, an offer for all of you who are listening. So this moving and expanding and all of this, it's really beautiful. And yesterday I got this inspiration that I haven't really shared like a special giveaway for a while now, and I love all of you, and those of you who are my companions, and I wanted to make something special. So I saw, wow, I still have these medallions that I made, my ascension medallions, after a while, and I went, wow, I still have them, I didn't know. And they come in this box with A, with the letter A, which means ascension. That's why I said A. So I have three of those available, and the offer is that if you write to me, there's three of those. These are for our sacred initiations, for devotion to ascension, and these are theme in the back. They're words I am, so they connect with the I am frequency, with the diamond ray, with the purity, about the heart ascension. And they're a bit heavy, but they are meant and created as a devotional piece, not like a modern jewelry that you wear, you know, like fashion jewelry. So I have three of those that I can spare. So if you want to purchase all of my mastery courses at once, you already get them at discount. And the offer is that you also will get a free, totally free, at the expense of my own shipping, this ascension medallion for your ascension journey and devotion to this path of purity, of complete attunement to the I Am presence. And these, I started to make them last year, and I still love them. They're a bit, you know, unique, but I love them. They feel very powerful to me. So if you want to receive, and you haven't done the courses, and maybe you've been like pondering whether to engage in them or not, then this is the time, because you get a free Ascension medallion and you get the discount already if you buy all 7 initiations. And these come in this sacred bag. And if not, then they're just gonna stay for later time. Everything always gets its purpose. This is what I want to share with you. Trust, sometimes things are not crystallized just because your mind doesn't know it. And why is this not this way? And why is it not? Remember times when you were like, ah, that's why. Well, these times always come. And even if they don't, you know, Source is still everywhere and everything has its unfolding, and the part of us that sometimes nibbles at us and it's like biting at us and, you know, wants things its own way, we're really fully surrendering that part and we're saying, you know, you've kept me hostage for long enough. You know, there's been this lots of healing through these ancestral lines, but now, you know, you're really ready to claim your inner freedom, but not just to claim it, but to live it. So you are your freedom and you live your freedom. And stay tuned for the sun coming up next. And I'll talk to you soon. So much love is in power. Bye-bye. So welcome to this third part of the video, where I will be tuning into a crystalline song for us, the song of our inner freedom, the song of the attunement through this gateway and universal energy that supports us on our ascension path. And to just bring forth the pure diamond frequency of the angels and the seraphim. So I'm going to tune this through the 528 hertz first, and then I'm just going to play a plain sound with my new crystal bowl. It's a singing bowl and it has platinum butterflies in it, which are pretty awesome. They really represent the Serapina light frequency. And I'm only going to play it like this because the sound of this camera is not pretty good, so the rest of the sound comes out too robotic. So, okay, tuning in. As you're watching this video and participating vibrationally, I ask you to just put your hands on your heart to attune to the angelic frequency, to call in your angels, to connect with the purest light, the diamond light, the frequency of the seraphim, and just put yourself in a comfortable space where you really feel sacred and whole and at home as we begin. So whenever I start, I never know what's going to come through, but it's always something that needs to, and I just trust, I just surrender, and so we will see.
Oh.